another one in we are getting exception handling.
Okay.
And then we discuss about access specifiers sometime back from the day one. Okay, we are using public protected and all. Some guys asked me sometime back. I mentioned we'll see that at the end of the class.
Okay.
Access specifiers. Okay. That means what is public, protected and private. What are those? If you mention public, what happens if you write protected? What is the impact and all? Okay. We'll see this. Okay. And then we'll try to cover debug the Eclipse. Okay. That means debug your program in Eclipse. How to run in debug mode. Okay. That I will show you today. And tomorrow will, if time permits, tomorrow we'll try to start Selenium. Okay.
Hello.
Okay, guys. Did you guys implement it? I have given that regarding inheritance. Yeah, okay. Already it's there. Let me show here in my workspace also it is there. This is the program implemented by Bindu. Okay, just see forwarded that one after implementing. There is a class. Okay, calculations. Inside that, she implemented some of the methods for calculating area and perimeter of square and rectangle. Okay, like this Java people also. What they do is frequently used methods, whatever is required every time we need, right? Those kind of things they will identify and they will implement in some class. That classes they will provide to us in the form of jar. Whenever we install Java, we will get all these classes. Okay, those classes will be having some of the important methods like whatever we have written in this example. Okay, next job is once those classes are available, whenever it's required for us, for some task we need, if you want to calculate area of a square, just you need to identify where this method is available and then create an object for that class and then invoke this method. This method will perform the operation. Okay. Similarly, Java people also have implemented so many classes, inside classes, so many methods. Okay. Today we will see three important classes and then we'll go to exception handling and then access specifiers. Okay. In that previous example, calculations class is there. Once class is there, how to use it? Generally, program execution starts from main. So for that purpose, we wrote another class called main. Okay, it is extending calculations. Okay, so all the methods you will get here. Okay, extending. So if you want to use those here, what you supposed to do? Generally, by default, these methods in calculations are like non-static methods, right? You got those methods into subclass like a non-static methods, right? If you want to use non-static methods, what you supposed to do? You must create an object for that class and then use it, okay? Through inheritance process, this subclass got those methods, so we are creating object. Using object, we are invoking the required methods. Any doubt in this? It's clear, right? Guys?
Yeah,
good. Now, let me go to another class, some predefined class, string. Okay? See here, this is a class. String class. Okay? Class name is string. Before going to that, I want to explain something called notations. If it is a class name, right? Always you must follow Java standard. Every meaningful word. Every meaningful word. First letter should be capital. Did I explain these in earlier classes in the beginning?
Rice?
No.
Okay. So examples. See, for example, you are writing class called string. Already it is there. It is there. If consider you are going to use. So here how many words are there? Two words. Okay. So two words are there. Every word, every meaningful word, first letter should be capital. So S should be capital. Okay. Another class today. Okay, here, see here, I wrote another class, my user-defined class. String class methods examples, I'm going to explain here. Methods of the string class, three, four important methods. Okay, that's why I wrote a class. Here, if you guys observe, in string class methods, string is a one meaningful word, S is capital. Class is another word, that C is capital, methods, M is capital. Understood? Similarly, print stream. Okay? P is capital, S is capital. Like this, you must follow the Java notations while writing the classes and methods. Let me explain about method. Okay? Now, how to write a method? Generally, calculate. Area is there consider calculate area. Here every meaning in case of classes, every meaningful word first letter is capital. In case of methods, first word having small letter, remaining all are having capital. For example, calculate area. Okay. C should be capital. First word. First letter should be, sorry, lowercase. Next, second word onwards, first letter should be capital. Okay. And get length. Okay. Whenever you are writing your own classes, you should also follow these notations. Okay. If you don't follow also, it will work. But this is the best practice. If you are going to write some of the competitive exams and all, like OCJP, okay, Java Certified exam and all, there these things they will ask, some of the things. Okay. So understood how to write for methods. Okay. For methods.
Just a question regarding the last assignment. My program also is in the similar pattern. I also gave values of the measurements of the square and the rectangle in the program itself. I was thinking if we will be covering the syntax where we have to actually give the measurements of the square or rectangle, which receives the input from us. And then it stores, and then it uses in the calculations. So those type of examples we will be covering.
In this demo? Okay. Tomorrow I will cover that if you guys want. Generally, there is a method called readLine. What it will do is, you want to take the input from keyboard at the time of program execution. Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. There is a method called readLine. Okay. That readLine is available in one of the class input stream, it seems. Okay. We have to create an object for that, and then we have to call it. Tomorrow I explain that. The reason why I did not cover and I did not plan it also, because in our testing or in real time, we don't enter any data at the time of exam. Before, what we do is we will enter data from keyboard. That is correct. But in our testing, we don't use it. It will go and sit in some of the text fields or text area boxes. From there, there are some other method to read data from text field or text area or some input fields. Then we will use it. That is the reason I did not cover it. Okay, tomorrow if you guys want, I will explain that also. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
For methods, first word, first letter should be in lower case. Remaining all other words first letter should be capital. Okay. Similarly, while writing variables also, we have some notation for variables. Okay. For variables, everything should be in lowercase. Okay. Examples like area of rectangle. Okay, like this. And another one, something called constants. Okay, for constants, all the letters should be in uppercase. Okay, guys. For example, if you are going to write some constant like size, okay, size AT, like this, okay. Now, here we are going to see about now strings. See, string. String is a class type. Similarly, each class will act like a data type, right? So in a string, S is capital. So after that, it is a variable. Okay. String variable contains some data. Okay. Generally, till now, whatever we have used all the classes. For that, if you want to create object for those classes, what is the syntax we followed? Class name, space, some reference name. Variable name or object name, whatever you can call it, okay, equal to new and then class name, that means a constructor, right? This is how we created objects for all the classes till now. Let me write one more example like this we were doing, right? So class name and a reference variable name, new operator and then constructor. Similarly, for string class also, we do in the same way. In addition to that, we have another shortcut method. Directly, if you write something in the double quotes, okay, it will consider as line number 23. Okay, 21, 22 is similar to 23 only. Okay, so you can write in either way. Directly, you can write in double quotes, or else, like whatever is the standard syntax, you can use this one also. Okay, there is no difference between these two. Okay, now just what I did, I created three string variables, and then I'm trying to print the values of that string variables. Okay, so hello, varel, and welcome to Java class. These three are the okay. These three strings I assigned to three variables, and I'm
hello.